Good morning. Now I will introduce myself briefly. My first name is Hong Yi. My last name is Liu. I was born and raised in China. Now I'm studying in Nanjing Normal University, and I major in French language and literature. I'm currently applying for TESOL MA. I have never studied in an English-speaking country before. Ever since I started learning English, it just grows on me. I want to show the beauty of its grammar and its pronunciation to more people. So I served as a volunteering English teacher in high school for 4 years, and I also teach TOEFL. When a student is getting the hang of what I'm teaching, a smile or a nod from him is more than anything in the world to me. I know that most of Chinese students are having trouble learning English, and I really want to help them. That's why I think this opportunity is important to me. Part 2. When facing the tricky problem 4 years ago, I would probably just give up the whole project, because this whole situation would look like a battle of egos to me. However, now I will make a different choice. It's about two people working together to get good grade, and it requires compromise, and I'm willing to take on more responsibilities. I will approach the issue in an empathetic manner, try and understand what my partner is feeling or going through, and I'm hoping we can have an open conversation about it and make him feel heard, not judged, and maybe get him to sharing a small percentage of our paper. And as for me, I'm pretty sure I'll manage to squeeze a lot into a day or a week and finish the paper. I think the attitude towards this situation is way more important than the choice that I make, because one can always make wrong choices in his life, but the attitude determines who he is and what he's capable of. I went to underprivileged areas for volunteering teaching, and this experience really changed the way I see the world and the way I feel about people. The kids living in poverty works harder. They are always happy, sunny, perseverant, warm-hearted, and surprisingly, their gratitude for what they already have. I'm just so lucky compared with them, but I'm still being, you know, calculating, and I keep asking myself, is it fair in every detail? Now I've come to realize that life isn't about being fair. Life is about helping others. It's about treating others with respect. By helping others, I become a better me. Part 3. Integrated content and language instruction is a pretty effective teaching method. Focusing on second language learners, it uses a combination of both specific content in different areas and academic language required in the rare task. First things first, teachers design each and every lesson according to students' abilities for clear outcomes, and then goal-directed interactions are encouraged, developing the skills of reading, writing, listening, and speaking. Last but not least, review activities are essential for consolidating prior knowledge. All of this paved the way for high proficiency, good understanding, and even team spirit. I remember preparing for a GRE test. Our teacher taught the quantitative part using a content and language integrated approach. At the beginning, he outlined some math problems and math formulas in Chinese. Well, he had to make sure that we all knew how to work them out in our first language. And then he changed all those terms in English, like arithmetic sequence, geometric sequence, things like that. And once we understood them in English, it'll be quite easy for us to answer them. He also would set up some traps from time to time. He would have us all together discussing some math problems, looking the same at first glance, but turn out to be totally different, because one is with a decrease 2 and the other is with decrease by. I think the advantage of this approach is that students figure it out quickly, as long as it be not too bad at math and memorizing vocabularies. However, the thing is that ultimately they tend to forget the meaning of a large number of math terms, because I think in this specific area, the English vocabularies are not packed to their math meanings. I mean, they only function as a kind of a bridge between Chinese and math, but not the solutions themselves.